Okay, the first of the problem is about a trapeze, which I don't know that anybody, I mean, it's kind of easy to measure the height of a trapeze, but, I don't know, maybe you would use the formula to find the speed of the trapeze. That's probably a little bit harder to identify. So, yesterday the hurricane, problem was about speed as well, about like velocity of the wind and the air pressure, and it was a square root equation. So I just want to make sure you're connecting square root equations being the inverse of quadratic equations. So we did all of these problems about dropping objects off of buildings, or like an object falls and the time and the height modeled a quadratic. It was like negative 16 t squared, and then went on from there. We also did projectiles. Projecting an object made a parabola. And so those quadratic functions, we did a lot, right? So we're seeing a lot of word problems that are inverse. So this is talking about gravity and speed. And this was also talking about gravity and the time it takes something to go somewhere, right? So this t squared inverse becomes a square root equation. So those kind of rewritten are representing. This says that the speed is 7, that's the velocity. This is 2 times gravity, so 9.8 is meters per second. If we were talking feet per second, we would put 16 in there. And then the 2 I'm interested in, like, I don't know this formula, maybe I've done it in physics, but I'm interested is related to the 2a in quadratics. The quadratic formula divided by 2a, negative b over 2a. I'm interested in that too. I think it's related. And then we don't know the height. We're trying to figure out h of this trapeze artist. So. All right, you guys, what did you find for 2 times 9.8? And so here now we have to clear this square root. So we will square both sides. We get 49 equals 19.6 times h. Notice when I square, the radical goes away and nothing changed underneath there. It's just that the square root part is gone. Divide by 19.6. And what did you guys get? So let's answer in a complete sentence. The height of the path, the swing path, is 2.5 meters, which is pretty high for a trapeze artist. Have you guys heard of the Sailor Circus in Sarasota? It's like a kid's circus. Who's heard of it? One person. It's really cool. They do summer camps, they do classes, so like the families of Sarasota know all about it. Like you can sign your kid up for soccer or you can sign them up for trapeze lessons. Or they walk the tightrope, they juggle, they do like con acts. It's pretty popular in Sarasota. Like the ring, who's been to the Ringling Museum? So good. If you guys haven't been, it's right in Sarasota. You can go see the art for free on Monday. This summer you should go. It's really cool. Okay. Moving on. We don't talk about, you know, in science the need to measure a trapeze path, but you know, swings are mechanical and pendulums are mechanical. So I could really see this being used in some kind of mechanical work or engineering. This one I find really interesting is the shoulder height of an elephant related to the age of the elephant. And I know you guys look at this and you think that this is made up. Like, this looks, you know, magical. Like, do you guys think this is really calculating the height of an elephant? Like, you know, how'd they come up with this, right? You're kind of just doing it.
So these textbooks are just getting better and better. And we've been kind of fact checking this, and this is accurate. What I think happens here
is they study the elephant, they document the height,
and it documents the age, and it makes a scatter plot, just like I said yesterday. So, this is different ages of elephants, and this is their shoulder height, and they just, you know, they're just documenting this. They put this into a software, a computer program, or maybe they even calculate it by hand before software did everything for us. And this is what the line of fit looks like. You know, it looks like a cube root graph. So they do the regression, which we've done in our calculators, linear regression, quadratic regression, and they see, in fact, that the best equation to model the relationship between age and shoulder height is a cube root function. So I'm not really sure what this 62.5 is, except for that it must be, it's 62 centimeters times the cube root of years plus 75.8. Now, I do know what 75.8 represents. What is the 75.8, Miss Elephant? 75.8 means elephant. Kayla, what are you thinking?
What do you think that could mean? This looks like Hubble Jobble numbers. I don't know anything. But I did figure this one out after I looked at it long enough. What's that mean for elephants?
Sienna, what do you think? 75.8, what's that mean for elephants?
What's happening here? Someone's got it in every class. Somebody got it. Kayla, you got it? It's a starting height, right? If time is zero, if the it's a baby elephant just born, zero times 62.5, that's all zero. So 75.8 centimeters must be how tall an elephant is when it's born. Have you guys seen a baby elephant? They're big. They're not very small. So we Googled this. This is like 2.5 feet, and sure enough, that is accurate for the height of an elephant when it's born. So our function here, while it looks made up, this is the starting height. You put how many years it's been alive, you cube root that, multiply it by this constant. This must be some kind of growth rate. And then you can predict either their height or their age.
Okay. You find a herd of elephants, a whole family of elephants, you're totally pumped. Do you know how old they are? Do you know their age? No. Can you measure their shoulder height? Maybe. It's going to be hard to get up to them, but you could measure it, and you have no idea how old they are. You didn't know them their whole life, right? Or maybe you're studying their skeletons. Maybe you find their remains. You can measure their shoulder height, and then you will know how long that elephant was alive for. Okay? So, this biologist goes out studying elephants, loves elephants, makes the whole journey. Is this biologist also a mathematician, you think? Mm-hmm. I mean, yeah, maybe. Maybe they're also very good at math. Maybe it's a team of people. Somebody who really loves elephants and wants to go in the wild and study them. Somebody with them that's very good at data analysis. But just going out and finding elephants and watching them and not knowing how to record the data and use the data isn't going to make science. You're not going to get funded. You're not going to have research, right? So people love elephants. They go study biology, zoology at USF. They're asking, why do I have to take AP statistics? I just want to study elephants. You're not going to be able to record any data on elephants if you can't make it into numbers,
if you can't graph it and figure out what the software is saying, right?
Alright, what's 174.2 divided by 62.5? All right, we have to clear this cube out. Raise both sides to a power of 3. What's that? Isn't it 21.6?
All right, so it turns out this elephant been alive 21 years. This male elephant. So we looked it up. Male elephants look like mid 40s. So it's like a middle-aged elephant. Hello?
Show me 1 through 10 real quick
before you go. So this elephant, is it a loner? Does it appear to be a parent in the elephant herd? It's been alive 22 years. When you study the elephant, you're now gonna know how old it is, how long it's been around the other elephant. You have a question? So, the relationship between the age times 62.5. So, let's say it's 8 years old. Like, 8 times 62 would make this, a lot of centimeters, right? It's the cube root of 8, so it's 2 times 62. So, it's not a direct proportion, the years. I'm 2 years old, I do this. I'm 3 years old, I do this. It's the cube root of years. So it's like 3 years. My brain thinks of it as divided by 3, but it's obviously more complicated. You know what I mean? Yeah, it stops here. That's why I didn't put an arrow this way. For all word problems that have to do with time, it's still modeling a cubic. We just cut it off. You don't know what it is. So they just did, they found an elephant. Maybe they study an elephant in the zoo from birth to death, right? At 1 year old, it's 75 centimeters. At 2 years, it's 80. At 10 years old, how high is it? It's 200. And then at 20 years old, it's 250. So they have this elephant. And then they collect data from all of the zoos in the world. And this is another elephant. And so they collect, hundreds of different tests, and they plot it. And then they see the relationship between those numbers. So you learn how it's called regression. And we did it in our calculators with quadratics. But you learn how to do that by hand in higher math classes. Software does it. No. But if we were to put this in our data of elephants in our calculator and hit cubic regression, that's what our calculator would tell us. Because it would find the line. And the line of fit isn't straight. And the line of fit is not a U shape. The line of fit is very specifically the way cube root function works.
Do we have to use the 10,000th place for the decimal?
No.
Okay.
It doesn't say. I wish it said every time. More than wrong, too.
So I can just use the 100th?
A lot of people wanted to put 22 since we were talking about ages, and people don't say 22 and a half or 21 and a half. Alright. What's that? Yeah. And it's like after 6 months, just kind of. No, I probably did it until a year and a half. Like 13 months. 13 months in a week. You can't do it until you're a parent, though. Okay. Let's try one more. So, for whatever reason, guys, 10 is no solution. Check your workout. You should have got -4. You should have got -4, and then when you plug in -4 to the equation, it doesn't work. Did you check these? You had to check them. All right, y'all. So our equations today aren't too different from this. We're working from example 5 today. Example 5, solving an equation with a rational exponent. So they're not radicals, but they're rational exponents, which you know are related. So I actually have some steps for you today. I didn't give you steps yesterday. Here are some steps. So this is referring to example 5 on page 476. These problems are less familiar to you than yesterday. You guys, I just kind of let you know. Go yesterday and try them. You figured them out really well. You'll probably have a little more questions about these today, though they aren't any more difficult. Well, 28-29 are pretty tough. Number 1, isolate the base and the exponent. So isolating the radical was really important yesterday. Today, it's important you isolate the base. So what do you mean? It was 4x to the 1/2. You have to see that it's the x that has the 1/2 and not the 4. So you have to move everything away from the base and the exponent. Step 2 is what's brand new to you. I don't think you've ever done this in any other type of problem. You raise each side to the reciprocal of the exponent. So the reciprocal of the exponent, you just raise each side. So if the exponent
you raise each side to the 4 over 3. And it works out really well. That's probably the easiest part of the problem, is step 2, the new part. Because anything times down, it's reciprocal is 1. I'm so annoyed. Okay, after you raise each side to the reciprocal,